Repaglinide is an antihyperglycemic used to improve glycemic control in diabetes. In this video, let's find found. What is repaglinide? What is repaglinide used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking repaglinide? How does repaglinide work? How to use repaglinide? What is repaglinide? Repaglinide is an antidiabetic drug in the class of medications known as meglitinides, and was invented in 1983. Repaglinide is a medication used in addition to diet and exercise for blood sugar control in type 2 diabetes. It is sold by Novo Nordisk under the Prandin in the United States, Gluconorm in Canada, SurePost in Japan, Repaglinide in Egypt, and Novonorm elsewhere. In Japan, it is produced by Dainippon Sumitomo Pharma. What is repaglinide used for? As an adjunct to diet and exercise to improve glycemic control in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Contraindication. Repaglinide is contraindicated in people with diabetic ketoacidosis, with or without coma, type 1 diabetes, co-administration with gemfibrozil, known hypersensitivity to drug or inactive ingredients. Side effects. Common adverse events include metabolic, hypoglycemia, 31%, respiratory, upper respiratory infection, 16%, sinusitis, 6%, rhinitis, 3%, gastrointestinal, nausea, 5%. Diarrhea, 5%. Constipation, 3%. Vomiting, 3%. Musculoskeletal. Arthralgia, 6%. Back pain, 5%. Other. 11%. Paresthesia, 3%. Serious adverse events include cardiac ischemia, 2%. Angina, 1.8%. Deaths due to cardiovascular events, 0.5%. Pharmacodynamic. Insulin secretion by pancreatic beta cells is partly controlled by cellular membrane potential. Membrane potential is regulated through an inverse relationship between the activity of cell membrane ADP-sensitive potassium channels, ABCC8, and extracellular glucose concentrations. Extracellular glucose enters the cell via GLUT2, SLC2A2, transporters. Once inside the cell, glucose is metabolized to produce ADP. High concentrations of ADP inhibit ADP-sensitive potassium channels, causing membrane depolarization. When extracellular glucose concentrations are low, ADP-sensitive potassium channels open, causing membrane repolarization. High glucose concentrations cause ADP-sensitive potassium channels to close, resulting in membrane depolarization and opening of L-type calcium channels. The influx of calcium ions stimulates calcium-dependent cytosis of insulin granules. Repaglinide increases insulin release by inhibiting ADP-sensitive potassium channels in a glucose-dependent manner. Mechanism of action. Repaglinide activity is dependent on the presence functioning beta cells and glucose. In contrast to sulfonylurea insulin secretagogues, repaglinide has no effect on insulin release in the absence of glucose. Rather, it potentiates the effect of extracellular glucose on ADP-sensitive potassium channel and has little effect on insulin levels between meals and overnight. As such, repaglinide is more effective at reducing postprandial blood glucose levels than fasting blood glucose levels and requires a longer duration of therapy, approximately 1 month, before decreases fasting blood glucose are observed. The insulinotropic effects of repaglinide are highest at intermediate glucose levels, 3 to 10 millimoles per liter, and it does not increase insulin release already stimulated by high glucose concentrations, greater than 15 millimoles per liter. Repaglinide appears to be selective for pancreatic beta cells and does not appear to affect skeletal or cardiac muscle or thyroid tissue. Half-life. 1 hour. Dose. Type 2 diabetes mellitus. Indicated as an adjunct to diet and exercise to improve glycemic control in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus. May be dosed 2, 3, or 4 times a day in response to changes in meal pattern. Starting dose. HbA1c less than 8%, 0.5 mg PO, before each meal. HbA1c greater than or equal to 8%, 1 to 2 mg PO, before each meal. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about Repaglinide we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.